Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part two of multiplying numbers by powers of 10, and it's an introduction to scientific notation. You need to already be familiar with multiplying and dividing with decimals, understanding exponents, and working with positive and negative exponents. These are the problems we do on this video. We also define scientific notation. And in the next video, I'll be showing you how to write a number in scientific notation. All right, let's do 30 times 10 to the negative 1. So what we notice here is the exponent on 10 is negative. So we have to remember what that means. What does that mean, 10 to the negative 1? Well, it means 30 times 1/10, doesn't it? Okay. And then, of course, what you're really doing then is doing 30 divided by 10. I could also write it that way, 30 divided by 10. And that is going to give us an answer of 3. Hopefully, you can do that. Now, so what's happening when you multiply by 10 to some number where the exponent is negative? You're really dividing by a power of 10. So notice this is like 30 divided by 10 to the first. So 30 times 10 to the negative 1 is the same thing as 30 divided by 10 to the positive 1. And then what happens when you divide by a power of 10? In other words, when you divide by 10, really the exponent goes 1 to the left. So remember when we did 30 times 10 to the first? We had the decimal here right at the end, and you move 1 to the right for this exponent. So we would get to add a 0. If I'm going to do 30 times 10 to the negative 1, what happens is I move my decimal 1 to the left. Because I'm going to get a smaller number. Because remember, multiplying by 10 to a negative exponent really is like dividing. Okay? Dividing by 10 to the first power. So you're going to get a smaller number, and our answer will be 3. So let's try that on another problem. How about 17.35 times 10 to the negative 1? So how would we figure this out? Well, remember, this means divided by 10 to the positive 1. If you want, you could write it like that, or you could write it times 1/10. Okay? What we're learning is the shortcut way. We're going to move it 1 to the left. So, one way people remember this is that if it's a negative exponent, we go to the left with a decimal point, and if it's a positive exponent, we go to the right. So, in this case, we're going to the left, so our answer is 1.735. How about 8.462.91 times 10 to the negative 3? All right, you don't see the exponent, do you? If you don't see, I'm sorry, you don't see the decimal, do you? So remember, if you don't see a decimal, it's really at the end. Think about if you were going to write this as many. 8.462.91, it's 846,291 whole dollars. So the decimal point would be here. And we need to move it 3 to the left because we're going to get a smaller number. Because remember what this means, just one more time. This means 8.462.91 divided by 10 cubed, which is the same thing as 8.462.91 divided by 1,000, right? You're dividing by 1,000, so you are going to get a smaller number. You don't need to write this out, but that's what it means. Okay, so what's the shortcut? We move the decimal 3 to the left. So our answer will be 8.462.91, right? So when you multiply by 10 to a negative number, you end up getting a smaller number, and it's because you're dividing by some power of 10. You're dividing by 1,000 in this case. All right, let's do a couple more. How about 53.82 times 10 to the negative 4. All right, so try this one on your own. Put the video on pause and try it. All right, again, it's times 10 to the negative 4, so I'm going to get a smaller number. Move the decimal to the left 4 places. Now, it's a little bit tricky. I don't have much room here. I'm going to move this to the right just a little bit. So if I were going to move it, 1, 2, I got to keep moving to the left more. So I'm just going to put a little space where I can put my decimal point. And what we do is we fill in these spaces with zeros. So we have the decimal point, 2 zeros, and then the rest of this number. So the answer here will be, and if you want, some people like to begin by writing a 0 point so they don't lose that decimal point. So you can do that. So you could either write your answer as 0.005382, or you could write it as 0.005382. A lot of times people put the zero first to show you, it's easier to see the decimal point. Sometimes the decimal point just sort of gets lost. That's really up to you. All right, so here's some 6 problems that I want you to try. Put the video on pause and try these problems on your own. Some have positive exponents, some have negative exponents. All right, let's do the first one. We have 4.26 times 10 to the third power, so we're going to get a bigger number, right? It's like multiplying by 1,000. So you need to move your decimal to the right, positive exponent, move it to the right 3 spaces. And that should give you 4,260. If you want, you could do this. Remember, you'd have to put an extra zero there. All right, next one. This time you're multiplying by 10 to the negative 2. That's like dividing by 100, right? Because it's 10 to the negative 2. So you're going to get a smaller number. We're going to move to the left 2 spaces. That's where your new decimal point will be. So you're going to have to put a zero there. So the answer will be 0.043 or 0.043. You could always put a zero in front of a decimal point. All right, next one, 6.91 times 10 to the first, bigger number, we moved the decimal to the right one, so that's 69.1. 8.403 times 10 to the negative 1, we're going to get a smaller number. Remember, anytime you multiply by a negative exponent, it's going to be smaller, so we're going to move the decimal to the left, so that will be 0.8403 or 0.8403. And here's 2 times 10 to the negative 4. Now, you don't see a decimal point, but you're going to get a smaller number, right? Because we have a negative exponent. So we have to remember where the decimal point is. It's after the 2, right? 2 could be thought of as 2.0 or just 2. So I'm going to move 4 to the left, which means I'm going to have to fill in 3 zeros here. So my answer is 0.0002 or 0.002. Hope I said that right. 0.0002, yes. All right, and 6.10 to the sixth, again, the decimal point would be here. You would have to move it to the right, but when you have a whole number, all you have to do is add that many zeros, tack them on to the end of the problem. So we would add 6 zeros. I don't want to say add 0 because, 6 plus 0 is still 6, but we're going to tack on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros, and we get 6 million. And hopefully that makes sense because 10 to the 6th is 1 million. So 6 times a million should be 6 million. Now there's something interesting about all of these problems I gave you. The original problem was written in what we call scientific notation. So I'm going to get rid of this here so you don't see all the stuff I did. Oops, got rid of the 2 also. Put that back. Okay. The original numbers here, 4.26, 4.3, 6.91, 8.403, 2, and 6, these are all numbers between 1 and 10. Notice they're all numbers between 1 and 10, and they're multiplied by 10 to some power. That's exactly what scientific notation is. The number here has to be a number between 1 and 10. So there's a single digit, 139. So the number in front of the decimal can either be a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9. And then you might not have anything after the decimal, as in these last two cases, 2. But you could. You could write it as 2.0 or 6.0. But there's a single digit, 1 through 9, and then a decimal point, and times 10 to some exponent. And that is what scientific notation is. All right, so here's the definition of scientific notation. In scientific notation, a number is written as the product of two factors. The first factor is a number between 1 and 10, and the other number is a power of 10. So here are some examples. The first number, all numbers between 1 and 10, because the first digit has to be anywhere from a 1 to a 9. Okay. And then the other number is a power of 10. Now, the reason we write things in scientific notation usually is for very large, very small numbers. So these last two are some examples of where this would take a lot of space, because if you move the decimal 30 to the right, I might not be able to fit it on one line in this video. Same thing for this other one. If I had to move the decimal 100 spaces to the left, just imagine how you would try to write that on a piece of paper. It's true that 5.3 times 10 squared or 8.01 times 10 to the negative 3, that really isn't a problem writing it out in standard form, which is just the actual number itself. But large numbers and very small numbers, it's easier usually to write them in scientific notation. They fit on the page. So what you've learned to do is to take a number that is in scientific notation, or at the beginning of the video, the numbers weren't even in scientific notation, but you wrote them in standard form. In other words, you did the multiplication and wrote out what the actual number was, and that's called decimal form. In the next video, we're going to take a number that is not in scientific notation. So we'll do problems like these. These are numbers in decimal form or standard form. And what we're going to do is learn how to write them in scientific notation. Just for fun, see if you could do it on your own without me telling you how to do it, and I'll put the answers up, and then maybe you'll learn it without having to look at the next video. But the next video will show it. All right, this one, if you did put it in scientific notation, would be 9.6 times 10 to the fourth. This one would be 4.52 times 10 cubed. This one would be 8.0 times 10 to the negative 3. And this last one would be 6.214 times 10 to the first. Now, let's see. That's what I think the answer is. The way you would check is now you could actually do this multiplication, which you learned on this video, and see if you really got to this answer. So if I took 9.6 and I moved it, the decimal 4 to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, I think you get 96,000. If you take 4.52 and move the decimal 3 to the right, I think you get 4,520. If you take the number 8 and move the decimal 3 to the left, 1, 2, 3, I think you get 0.008. And if you take 6.214 times 10 to the first and move the decimal 1 to the right, you get 62.14. So that's how you can check your answers. So I'm going to go over how to write a number in scientific notation on another video. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.